Good evening, family, friends, loved ones, and Schurz High School Class of 2020. I welcome you to the graduation ceremony for the Class of 2020. And I know this cannot replace a traditional ceremony, but I am hopeful that you at home will take this opportunity to celebrate all of the hard work and accomplishments of our eldest Bulldogs. Thank you again so much for joining us today. The ceremony will now begin.
Welcome students, staff, and family to our Class of 2020 graduation ceremony. I know this isn't how any of us picture our senior year to end. We were not able to have any of the senior events we had hoped for, and our last classes were done through a computer screen. Even though everything that is going on in our world and in our community seems bleak, this is still a time for celebration. This is a time for you to shed some light on all of your accomplishments over the last few years and to celebrate the next steps into your future. All of your hard work has paid off. Whether you are going to community college, a four-year university, or simply taking the year off, it is all something to be proud of. The past 4 years at Schurz have taught me the importance of perseverance. Perseverance through those last late nights or through any tough times you may have had. All your strength and effort has brought you to this accomplishment and will continue to bring you many more. This fall, I will be attending the University of Illinois at Chicago as an engineering major, where I know I will be able to persevere through future late nights and through future challenges, as I know all of you will too. I'd like to pass this over to our other salutatorian, Laura Perez.
I'd like to continue what Leslie was saying by telling the class of 2020 how proud I am of each and every one of us for getting through these tough times. And regardless of where we might be, we can be proud to say that we did it. We have crossed another milestone in our lives, and regardless of where we end up in life, always remember that the relationships we've formed and the community we have created only wants to see us succeed in any ways we can. Schurz has been our home for the past 4 years of our lives, and even though our time here has ended, the memories we have made will stay with us forever. A special thank you to all our teachers. Know that we appreciate every moment we spent in your classes, and we'll be sure to bring your lessons with us as we leave Schurz behind. I'll always remember Dunley for bullying me constantly, because I know she only wanted the best for me and wanted to push me towards the best that I could be. She put up with me for the past 3 years, and for that I am eternally grateful. And thank you especially to all our senior teachers for all the patience and the support you have given us to this ever-changing year. Even as I stand here today, I am unaware of what will come next. I will be attending Wright College in the fall and plan on transferring to a four-year university at the end of my sophomore year. The future isn't very clear, but just like every one of you, I have taken a step forward towards figuring out what I want to do in life. Although we are not giving this speech on stage as we look upon the sea of purple and gold, just know that our accomplishments are recognized and our strength during the state of the world does not go unnoticed. Good luck, class of 2020, and all your further challenges we'll face, and I hope your futures are bright, no matter where life takes you. Now it is my honor to introduce to you one of my best friends in the class of 2020's valedictorian, Erica Jean Panados.
Hello to all family, friends, teachers, administrators, and of course, my fellow graduates. My name is Erica Jean Panados, and I have the honor of presenting this speech to all of you as your Schurz High School Class of 20 valedictorian. It's difficult to ignore the reason as to why we've been subjected to graduate in such a manner. However, after 4 years of enduring multiple all-nighters, waking up at the crack of dawn, and strategically weaving through the halls to just barely make it to class on time, we are still, in fact, graduating. Going forward, we will all be moving on to do greater things with our lives, whether it's through engaging in a gap year program, working an internship, enlisting in the military, or going to college. One of the very first things that I remember hearing from my teachers in the first few days of starting high school was that our high school years would pass by extremely fast, and they were absolutely right. In the 4 years that I've attended Schurz, I have learned quite a lot. Whether they were academic lessons taught in the classroom, athletic lessons taught out on the volleyball court, on random life lessons with Mr. Spence and my full DP peers as we had our working lunch periods. All of the teachers, coaches, and mentors that I've had throughout my entire high school experience have all taught me valuable lessons that I will be sure to bring along with me as I trek through college. Ms. Dunley, who was my English teacher since my sophomore year, taught me all about rhetoric and essay writing. I really do think that I've only come to acknowledge myself as a decent writer thanks to her. I also learned that math definitely is not my strong suit. I want to apologize and thank Ms. Lazar, Ms. Rack, and Ms. Wisniewski for helping me, even though I knew and they knew I was struggling. Coach Rosendahl also taught me the importance of winning and losing and how much easier it is to achieve a shared goal if you work together as one unit. Furthermore, one of the biggest things I learned during high school is that being a full DP student is as difficult as I thought it would be. I endured the entry-level IB classes for freshman and sophomore year and moved on to take accelerated, much more difficult and stressful classes my junior and senior years. I was able to see myself bloom through my time in the program. I saw myself flourish greatly. I essentially transformed from a shy 14-year-old girl who avoided people that merely wanted to compliment the sweater I was wearing to a much less shy 18-year-old girl who is now very close friends with those same people that tried complimenting my sweater all those years ago. Then, their senior year, an unexpected time of our lives, to say the least. We returned to Schurz in September thinking that this would be our year, our final year to decide what path we would take after high school, to participate in extracurriculars, to engage in the senior exclusive activities, to attend prom, and to walk across the stage and receive our diplomas on our graduation day. However, for me personally, and I know that my senior volleyball teammates feel the same, things began to look dull starting in October, as we were not able to play the last few games of our season and have our senior night. The CTU strike took place at the same time, and before we knew it, we went from winning conference our junior year to being called cheaters at what we didn't know was our very last game. Then 2020 came, and we all know the situation as it stands. Everything was suddenly snatched away, leaving us with feelings of anger, sadness, and regret. We left Schurz in March, anticipating that we would only be in quarantine for a couple of weeks. Despite all that's happened, the truth is that we still did it. We still went through all 4 years of high school and are still going to continue to face the future challenges that await us, even if the future seems a bit gray right now. I personally still feel that I can do great things at the school that I have ultimately chosen to attend. I will be attending the University of Illinois at Chicago as an undecided student, which will only expose me to a great variety of perspectives, especially in the state that the world is in right now. I'd like to also say thank you to all of my friends that have grounded me and each other throughout the course of these last 4 years, especially Uka, Jasmine, Terry, Isabella, Laura, Brianna, and Evelyn. I'd like to also extend this thank you to my family as well. To my older brother for pushing me to thrive academically, my younger brother for ignoring me whenever I saw him in the halls, and of course, my parents for driving and picking me up from school, attending all of my volleyball games and supporting me through thick and thin. Class of 2020, it's been quite an experience. With all the uncertainties taking place right now, with COVID-19 and the recent protest of a long-term issue, I am certain of one thing. We have rolled with the constant punches that our senior year and high school life in general has thrown at us. We as a whole are resilient, and I'm positive that we can overcome and make the best out of all of the challenges that await. I only wish all of you the best of luck, no matter where we all decide to go and what we decide to pursue with our lives. Without further ado, I'd like to now pass on the spotlight to our principal, Dr. Rodriguez. Good luck to everyone, and I hope you all stay safe and healthy. Thank you.
Schurz class of 2020. What a year it's been. If someone had asked me in January what my biggest worry was, I might have said something like the SAT, my boss coming to visit me, our attendance rate, our on-track rate, the kinds of things principals worry about day and night. I most certainly would not have said a global pandemic that would shut down the country, shutter schools, close businesses, and turn our lives completely upside down. How swiftly and abruptly it all happened. Figuring out how to teach and learn remotely without any preparation for students, families, or teachers has been difficult for everyone. I've been thinking back to my 18-year-old self and how I would have handled this situation, and the truth is, not too well. The ways in which you are supporting your family, friends, loved ones, and yourselves are incredible, and more than anyone can ask of any young adult. It's been over 2 months since the city has closed down. To me, it feels like 2 years. And the longer we move through this time, the more normal it feels. We settle into new ways of existing, whatever that means for us, and after a while, it just becomes the way things are. Not too long after we began sheltering in place, people talked about the day we would return to normal, when we will get back to work, back to school, back with our friends, maybe go to the beach or go see a movie. While those things will inevitably happen, they may not look like they did when we left them. The pandemic got real for me on March 19, when a projected 2-week closure turned into over a month. Shortly after that, there were news reports of school districts in other parts of the country closing down for the rest of the year. I knew that it was only a matter of time that the same would be true for us. It was March 20th when I began asking myself these questions. If I had a chance to do this year over, because it was so messed up, what would I do differently? What would I do differently as your principal to serve you and your families? What are those normal things that I do that get in the way of the goals that I want to achieve? What are those normal things that are out of my control that I allow to get in the way as I pursue my goals? It is now these questions that guide my work as I head into the summer and begin planning for next year, even though I really don't know what life will look like in the fall. What I'm trying to say is that I am committed to not returning to normal, and I want you to consider the same. Ask yourselves these questions right now. If you could do this year over, what would you do differently? What are those normal things that you do, or those normal things around you, that prevent you from being your best self? Take this difficult situation that we're in and make it an opportunity to transform yourself. Do not allow circumstances to control you, but rather take control of them by emerging on the other side better, stronger, wiser, and more determined than ever to live the life you want to live. No more excuses to justify why you do not reach your goals. No more waiting around for life to just happen to you. No more living a life other than the one that you want. I will give you a small but powerful trick to start. Whenever you catch yourself thinking that you can't, you need to tell yourself that you can. In fact, don't wait to tell yourself. Tell yourself you can whenever you think about it. When you wake up in the morning, as you move throughout your day, before you go to bed, tell yourself that you can lead the life that you want and nothing is going to get in your way. No longer will you let the old normal prevent you from making your life what you want it to be. You have one shot at this, and you need to make every day you have on this planet count. If there is one thing that I do not want for you, it is to grow old and look back on your life, wondering what it could have been if you had just done those few things differently. So commit to not returning to normal and leading a better, stronger, and more determined life. There is no better time than now. You have made me proud to be your principal. I am grateful that you are and always will be a part of our Bulldog family. I truly miss all of you, and I wish you the very best as you enter the next chapter of your life. It is going to be a brilliant one.
Thank you.
And now for the time you've all been waiting for. If you don't have your cap on yet, go ahead and get it on. Grab that tassel on the left, and in the count of three, we are going to move it over to the right, and you will be official graduates of Schurz High School. One, two, three.